Hello guys, welcome to this new video on how to type chemical equation or reaction in Microsoft Word. I have been getting a lot of suggestions, required comments or requests for making a video on how to type chemical reaction. So here it is. Now there are three ways of writing chemical equation as such in Microsoft Word. Right. The first way is everybody know it is just like how we type equations, normal equation, mathematical equation. Just go to insert tab and then just click on equations. You will get just go to insert tab and click on equation, you will get equation editor, right? And here in a subscript, okay, this is H2, then plus half O2, half I will get, I just want to write this, okay, 1/2. Actually, you don't need to go and type this fraction if you type just 1/2 and press space, it automatically gets converted into a fraction. This is good thing about math auto, but it is the third option that I'll discuss in detail. Okay, now if I request you to please watch this all three ways, and at the end of this equation and at the end of this video, I'll give you some amazing tips that will save a lot of time. Okay, so please watch this video till the end. Okay, here we go. I again need this O2 gives, for getting this arrow I just go to symbol and it is available here since I am using it often. However, if you go to symbol and just, it is always available there. Okay, gives H2O. I'll go there and use this H2O. So this is just a normal way of writing equation with using GUI. It is good, it is quite user friendly, and you have a GUI, so you can just see what you want and insert it and just start typing. However, this is not the efficient way. If you are having a lot of equations, then this is not the efficient way of typing, because it involves movement between mouse and hand movement from keyboard to mouse and back to keyboard, right? So there is another way of typing equation, that is typing equation is like ink equation. This is a recent addition to Microsoft Word. Just go to insert tab and equation and then just click on ink equation. So this scribbling pad will appear, and here if you whatever you scribble, it will, Microsoft Word will try to understand it and then convert it into equation. Okay, half O2, okay, I forgot to write half, 1/2. Okay, if there's something, some problem, you just have to erase it, 1/2, and then O2. Okay, I don't think that this will, yeah, this is a problem since I'm using mouse, so I am not having a very fine control over there. O2 gives, okay, H2O. Okay, I did pretty well. Yeah, this is one more way of writing equation in Microsoft Word, that is ink equation. This way is better if you are writing equation over a tablet or a PC where you have a touch screen and you can just scribble with your stylus or whatever you think you have, like a hand also. But doing this with mouse, it's quite cumbersome and it takes time too. Now the third way, which is the way I prefer and I recommend, is by using math autocorrect. Math autocorrect, if you go to options, word options and proofing and autocorrect option, you will find a math autocorrect tab. Now if you want to use this kind of shortcut, you just have to make sure that this box is checked, replace text as you type, this box is checked. And if you want to use a shortcut outside equation editor, then you have to check this box also, use math autocorrect rules outside math region. Okay, just make sure that these two boxes are checked, or at least use math autocorrect box is checked. So chemical equation, general chemical equation, So the first shortcut for equation editor is press, you have to press Alt equal to. Okay, I'll just type it. I'll just press Alt equal to and I'll get equation editor. This is for shortcut. And for subscript and superscript, just remember that you have to use underscore and caret for subscript and superscript respectively. Suppose if I want to type h2, just type h and 2 as a subscript. So anything that is following underscore will be converted into subscript. So, and the moment I press space, it gives a message to my autocorrect that you have to use your autocorrect feature, right? Plus half o2 underscore 2 use. Now for right arrow, actually there is option I can use hyphen and then right arrow key and this greater than sign, or I can use spelling mistake r-i-g-h-t-e-r-o-w, and after pressing space it to send message to autocorrect that okay, now you can do it. Then h underscore 2 space and then o. Right, so this is how I type the equation using my autocorrect. Now if I want to get a superscript, like I want to write h plus ion, okay, I'll just type code equation editor and type h and a plus. I want it on the as a superscript, so what I'll do is I'll just press caret sign, and then whatever follows caret sign will be converted into superscript. Just make sure that you don't have spaces. Suppose if you want to include spaces, then include everything under braces. Okay, this is h plus. Okay, now suppose if you want to include space in your superscript, then 3 and a. Okay, so if you just make sure that if you want to include spaces in subscript or superscript using this method of autocorrect feature, enclose superscript or subscript into a bracket. This is how you can use this method autocorrect feature to write subscript, superscript or right arrow. This will solve 60-70% of your equation typing skill. Itself is enough for typing 60-70% of chemical reaction. However, there are other things like getting equilibrium sign. Okay, for getting equilibrium sign, again you have normal ways to go to equation editor and that arrow, equation editor symbol, and then find symbol. It's quite a tedious job. So the shortcut way using math autocorrect to get equation equilibrium symbol sign is LRHAR. So again, I'll show it to you. Alt equal to get equation, equation editor, 2 and underscore 2 plus 3 h underscore 2 gives LRHAR, gives 3 n h underscore 2. Okay, I did a space there. Yeah, okay, so this is how I type equilibrium reaction. Just remember that LRHAR. At the end of this video, I made a table where I will see all the autocorrect shortcut key, right? And at the end of this video, I'll give you one more tip that useful for if you have a lot of chemical equation to type. Okay, so if you don't want to miss any of these tips, great shortcuts, please watch my complete video. Okay, for real reversible reaction, actually I tried to find it in symbol and math autocorrect, I could not find it. However, there is a trick to set this kind of arrow which represents a reversible reaction. So what you have to do is you have to go to equation editor and then type, because I have a reversible reaction where a plus b gives, for getting this irreversible reaction arrows, 21c4, and then I just have to remember this code 21c4 and then press Alt X to get this arrow. Okay, give C plus T. So this is how I get a reversible arrow. Suppose if you don't like this arrow, okay, if you want to have a right side arrow on the bottom, then you have to write 21c6 and then press Alt X. So this is for you. So just remember this number 21c4 and then press Alt X. Okay, good thing is, actually if you want to have something like this arrow, shortcut is down arrow. This represents something that is getting precipitated in a chemical reaction. What I'll write is A plus B gives C plus D, and so I want to write this arrow plus shortcut D-O-W-N-A-R-O-W and press space. So this is how I get it. For up arrow, suppose there is a gas liberation, okay, then I just have to write up arrow, backslash, and then up arrow. So just type it very fast. Alt equal to, let's just type it very fast. A plus B gives C plus D up arrow. Okay, this is how you get up arrow. Now suppose if you want to write something above this arrow or below this arrow. Okay, so how do I write it? What I do is I just have to write this thing backslash above, and whatever is inside the braces will automatically be and above all this. So I want to type above right arrow. So what I'll do is I'll just type A plus B and then right arrow. Now I want to type Ni plus Pt, which is a catalyst. Which is a catalyst for this. What I used to have to type is above, and then anything inside the braces will get converted into a text which will be above this arrow after pressing space. Pressing of space is very important. We do C. Okay. Similarly, if you want to type anything below the arrow, let us say like a temperature, you just write below and then space. I'll just again give you an example. P plus Q, this arrow, and I don't press space, right? Below, I write T equal to 1000 Kelvin, press space, and use R, right? This is I write above and below. Suppose if I want to write above and below, okay, so what I'll do is I just have to write above, then space, then below, and then space. I just can combine both of this shortcut above and below. I'll just give an example. A plus B, then arrow, C B O B above, T equal to 1000 Kelvin, plus space, and then I have to write below it. B E L O W, below, and P T is catalyst platinum, plus space, and give C. So this is very simple. Don't have to go to equation editor, search how to write above arrow, below arrow. It's quite tedious job, and it is not easy to find. This kind of thing is not easy to find in Microsoft Word. So now here is a bonus tip. Suppose if you're writing a thesis or a report which has to write some chemicals numerous times, what you can do is, I have an equation, I have this thing H2SO4 which is occurring multiple times in my report. So what do I do is I type this equation in equation editor. Okay, I type this equation chemical name H2SO4. Okay, and what do I do is I don't have to go to equation editor and type all these things. I just need a shortcut. So what do I do? I ask window over to remember this. I just have to copy it, copy, go to file, option, proofing, autocorrect. Now I've copied it. I have to go to autocorrect and use this setting as formatted text. So this is a text that I want. Suppose I don't want to type such a long thing with subscript and superscript. What I do is I type H2SO4. This is a shortcut for this. I can make any shortcut as I like, but let us say this is a shortcut which I want. When I type this and press space, this thing will come. Okay, I'll just say replace, it was already added. I'll press OK. Now whenever I type H2SO4 and press space, Mac autocorrect feature will detect that okay, this is a shortcut for this equation, for this chemical, and I have to correct it appropriately. So this is a bonus tip. So this, you can use it quite intensively in your thesis or your report or journal paper for the chemical or anything. It is not only for chemicals, for anything that you are typing it which has a predefined format, you can use this autocorrect feature for each and every, for everything you want. So coming to the summary, so this is actually a list of table. This is a table actually which gives you a summary of all the shortcuts that you are using for typing these arrows. And for subscript and superscript, it is actually caret sign and underscore. It is quite simple. So just remember this shortcut. Okay, if you want to have this kind of arrow. Thank you. if you have any suggestion, if you have any comment, if you have any feedback, please give it in my comments, in the comments section. And if you want to see more such videos, and if you don't want to miss any of the videos, please subscribe and press the bell icon.